Praise the Lord, God bless. Praise the Lord, God bless. My name is Minister Red, pastor of Christ Our Life Ministries, located in Augusta, Georgia on 308 Rose Street, directly behind the Walmart Lowe's on Bobby Jones Expressway, Interstate 520 heading west. I pray that you'll join us for our worship services every Sunday at 10 a.m. and for Bible study every Thursday night at 7 p.m. I'm sure you'll be blessed. Oh, just as well as I know you'll be blessed by today's message. Amen. And God has for us today. Got an anointed word, a strong word, a powerful word from on high. Amen. Want to ask forgiveness for not being here Thursday night. Amen. Starting a new job and they decided they want to work me like crazy on my new job. Amen. Hallelujah. Let me stop this thing right here. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord. Got a strong word for us today. A strong word. God is looking for dead men. Men who understand light and darkness. Amen, amen, amen. God bless you, Sister Peachy. Thank you for joining me today. I love you. Sorry about not being here Thursday night, but that new job put it on me. Amen. And I refuse to come and minister God's word, amen, without being locked into the spirit. God bless you, Brother Peachy. So much, amen, safety knowledge was dominating my head. Amen. They gave me 185 videos I had to watch. And I said, I'm going to get this 185 videos knocked out this week so I can enjoy, amen, my life the way I want to enjoy it, amen. But I thank God for my new job. I'm going to love my new job. It's not going to take me away from y'all anymore. Oh, I love you too, Brother Peachy, and I miss y'all just as much as y'all miss me. I'm telling you, I miss y'all just as much as y'all miss me, amen. God got a strong word for us today, a good teaching word too. It's a good teaching, strong word today about light and darkness. God is looking for dead men. Men who understand light and darkness. Men who understand light and darkness. Because I tell you, people don't understand light and darkness because you got the light which represents the hot, and then you got the darkness which represents the cold. But you got people just mixing the two. God bless you, Brother Redding. Thank you for joining me this morning, my friend. I love you. Amen. Hallelujah. We want to give the people the time to join the telecast. Amen. So we want to go before the Lord. Amen. With a praise and worship song. Oh, Sister Peachy, I missed y'all too. Oh, and Brother Peachy. Amen. I know I'm ready to give it to my friend. Amen, Sister Peachy. Brother Peachy, tomorrow's my sister's birthday, so I hope you went out and spent them $1 million on the birthday present for her. Amen, because she's worth $1 million. Hallelujah. Let us go before the Lord with a praise and worship song. Amen. Amen. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We're all gathered here. We're all gathered here in your presence, Lord. Yes, Lord.
With our arms open wide.
Yes. With our arms open wide.
With uplifted hands.
Oh, yes, Sister Peachy.
And with open hearts.
We welcome you to abide.
To abide.
Oh, we welcome you to abide in his open arms today. Oh, Lord, we need your spirit. We need your Holy Spirit. Right now. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Give us your spirit. Your Holy Spirit. Your Holy Spirit. Right now. Thank you. Thank you. Give it to us. We can't do nothing. We can't do nothing. But without me, you can't do nothing. Until you come you, Lord. We can't do nothing. But we are so unworthy to even call on your name. So please, so please, 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 Lord, hear our prayer. Don't let our coming be in vain. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We need your spirit, your Holy Spirit. See, it's the Holy Spirit. Right now, see, we got, we know it's a bunch of spirits, but we need the Holy Spirit. Yes, Lord.
Give us your spirit. Your Holy Spirit.
Yes, Lord.
Right.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord. God bless you, Featherstone. Thank you for joining me this morning, my friend. I love you, Featherstone. Hallelujah. Thank you for attending, amen, the services today here at Christ Our Life Ministries. God got a powerful word for us today. A word dealing with light and darkness. God is looking for dead men. Men who understand light and darkness. Hallelujah. He's looking for dead men. Dead men, because Adam killed all of us. And he's looking for us so that he can give us life again, the life that Adam did not choose for us to have. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we come boldly before your throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Lord, I want to thank you for waking us up this morning. We want to thank you for waking us up this morning, clothed in our right minds, still in the same house that we went to sleep in, still looking at the faces that we went to sleep looking at. Oh Lord, we thank you. We thank you that no tornado or no hurricane or no thunderstorm or anything came through and disrupted our living. Oh Lord, and because Mother Nature ain't disrupted our living, oh God, I pray that no human disrupts our living as well. Oh Lord, we love you today. It might be my voice that they recognize, and it might be my face that they know. But let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord. Oh yes, Lord, I need these words to be acceptable in thy sight. Oh, because you are the one that giveth me life. And I need my words to be acceptable in thy sight, my strength and my redeemer. It's in Jesus' mighty name that we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. God bless you. God bless you. God is looking for dead men. Men who understand light and darkness. Because I tell you, the way we're living right now, the way it's going right now, I'm starting to wonder if the church understands the difference between light and darkness. God got a powerful word for us today to help us to understand the source. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Let us go here with my verse that I always like to start with. It says, and you have he quickened who was in darkness, who was dead in trespasses and in sin, in darkness. But when were we in darkness? When were you, when were I, when were we in darkness? When we were in time past, when we walked according to the course of this world that is currently in darkness, according to the prince of the power of the air. God bless you, Brother Kirk Smith. I love you. Featherstone's on there with me too. Amen, Brother Smith and Brother Featherstone, my two sons. Hallelujah. Walking in the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. That is key. That is key right there. Walking in the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. Now we're going to see if you are walking with the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. The spirit. Remember, the spirit. The walking with the spirit that now worketh in the spirit of disobedience. Hallelujah. Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not unto thine own understanding. Even though he has quickened us, who was dead in trespasses and in sin, that does not give us the liberty to go back and to lean unto our own understanding. He says, because understanding is having insight or good judgment. So you see we ain't gonna have, you, now at no time does Pastor Red ever have insight or good judgment. No, it is the Christ life in me that has the insight and the good judgment. Pastor Red never has good insight or good judgment. Jesus told the rich young ruler, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God. So if Jesus is telling this rich young ruler he ain't good, then Pastor Red sure ain't gonna say he good. And for that reason, this verse is telling me not to lean to my own understanding. Don't lean because, you know, because the insight that I got and the good judgment that I got came from the knowledge of good and evil from that tree. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not to thine. How in the world can you lean to your own understanding if they're saying to trust in the Lord with all? So you got to trust in him and stay out of the realm of having insight or good judgment. In all thy ways, see, you got to trust in the Lord with all thine heart, but then you still got a way. So in all thy ways, acknowledge him. See, acknowledge him. Accept or admit the existence of truth. See, in all thy ways, you got to accept and admit the existence of truth, and he shall direct thy path. Proverbs 4:5-7. Get wisdom. 1 Corinthians 1:30 says, he has been made unto us wisdom and righteousness and sanctification. Get wisdom. That means getting the Lord. Get understanding. Understanding of the Lord. Forget it not. Get the Christ life that'll give you insight. Who has insight? He won't give it to you. He has it. Minister Red supposed to be dead. If dead people don't have no say so in nothing in the land of the living. So if we're gonna be in the land of the living, then we have to allow him to have total preeminence, having insight or good judgment on his part, not on our part. Get wisdom, get understanding, forget it not, neither incline from the words of my mouth. Forsake her not, that is wisdom, and she shall preserve thee. Love her, and she shall keep thee. Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, and with all thy getting, get understanding. Get understanding. See, we like leaning to our own understanding. We like we don't want to understand God's way. We want to do things our way. But there's a reason why we do things our way, and we're going to explain that in today's teaching. 2 Timothy 2:7. Consider what I say. Consider what I say. And the Lord give thee understanding in all things. See, that's why I said trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Because if you trust in him with all your heart, then the Lord will give you understanding in all things. See, don't lean to your own understanding. Don't do that. All you got to do is trust in him, and he will give you understanding in all things. If you ain't trusting in God, and you lean into your own understanding, I tell you, it's going to end in death. There's a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. But you think that, because you know, you understand what you want to understand. You don't got God's understanding. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and the Lord give thee understanding in all things. Here we go. Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. I want to take something from him. He breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. Not life, just the breath of it. He gave him a taste of electricity. He gave man electricity, but man needed a source to continue providing him electricity. Now, God breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. I want to know who's breathing in your ear. See, the enemy breathes into the ear. God breathes into the nostrils, breathe life into the nostrils. And so when man ate from the, well, let's go here first. Genesis 2, 15 and 17. And the Lord God took the man, that he breathed the breath of life into his nostrils, and put him in the garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat, take information from, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not take information from it. For in the day that thou take information from it, thereof thou shalt surely die. Now, man takes everything in through the ears. Faith coming by hearing and hearing by the word of God. You have to be quickened. You know how God quickens you? Through the hearing of faith. If the soul, when man ate, he fell in darkness. He fell in the darkness. He had light. He had light, but he didn't understand. See, it was to trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not to thine own understanding. See, the enemy made Eve of an understanding. You know, she thought she understood something, but she didn't understand that he was trapping her in darkness. If the soul is left in darkness, see, God don't care nothing about the earth, Sue. He cares about the soul. See, John 6 and 63. It is the spirit that quickeneth. It's the spirit that don't want to leave the soul in darkness. The flesh profit in nothing. God ain't thinking about your earth suit. Your earth suit. Our earth suit is laden with sin. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. If the soul is left in darkness, sins will be committed. If the soul is left in leaning to its own understanding, sins will be committed. If the soul is left in darkness, sins will be committed. If the soul does not acknowledge God in all its ways, the soul will be left in darkness and sins will be committed. The guilty one is not he who commits the sin, but he who causes the darkness. Hear that now. The guilty one is not he who commits the sin, but he who causes the darkness. See, Satan was the guilty one. See, Eve was the guilty, Adam and Eve was the guilty ones who committed the sin. But Satan was the one that caused them to come into darkness. If the soul is left in darkness, sins will be committed. But you know what 1 Peter 2 and 9 says? You are a chosen generation of royal priesthood whom God has called out of darkness and into his marvelous light. God has called us out of darkness. When? And you have me quickened, who had dead in trespasses and in sin, wherein in time past you walked according to this world in darkness, according to the prince of the power of the air, the one that got us in the darkness, walking with the spirit that got us in the darkness, that now walketh, that now worketh in the children of disobedience. God hath called you, me, us, out of darkness into his marvelous light. And John 3:19 says, and this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world. The understanding of light, the understanding of God. Light is coming to the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. Men love darkness rather than they love light. Why do men love darkness rather than light? I got an answer for you. Because man is double-minded now. Man ate from that tree. See, like the man ate in Genesis, man ate from that tree. So when man ate from that tree, man turned himself into a light switch. He turned himself into a light switch. He turned himself into a double-minded creature. James 1:8 says, a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. He is unstable. There is no way for a double-minded man ever to stable himself. He will always be unstable. This is Bible. The Bible says a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. That's why we have to acknowledge him in all thy ways. Acknowledge him, and he said, direct thy path. Because if he doesn't direct your path is always going to be an unstable path. Always going to be an unstable path. If we say we have no unstableness, if we say we have no unstableness, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. See, that's what I said. If we deceive ourselves, the truth, which means no acknowledgement is in us, Brother Peter. Acknowledgement. Accept and admit the existence of truth. Then there is no acknowledgement in us. And if there is no acknowledgement in us, then we can just throw Proverbs 3:5-6. At the window. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not to thine own understanding, which is sin. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. I tell you, if we say we have no unstableness, if we say we have no sin, then we deceive ourselves, and we're never going to acknowledge him. The truth is not in us, which is acknowledgement. Except to admit the existence of truth. There will be no acknowledgement in us. Here we go. See, we're light switch, Brother Peter. Adam ate from that tree the knowledge of good and evil. This dude turned us into a light switch. The Lord, 1 Samuel 6:7, the Lord seeth not as man seeth. For man looketh on the outward appearance. That's why it is the spirit that quickeneth the flesh profitably. God ain't thinking about no light switch. Only reason why you need a light switch is because you can't touch electricity. You better not touch it. You're gonna die. Man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looks on the heart. See? Trust in the Lord with all thy heart. Because God is going to look on your heart to see if you're going to acknowledge him in all your ways so that he can direct your paths. The Lord looketh on the heart. We're light switch. This is the thing about the light switch, what you need to know. God bless you, Kobe. Thank you for joining me today. You jumped in right where I'm finna get into my teaching real good. Talking about the light switch. Oh, yeah, Brother Peachy. The light switch shows a light. Yes, it does. I'm finna teach you how. The light switch. You got the on and off switch. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. You got the light switch. It might be on. Even if you turn the light switch off, it's still hot up there. Meaning, all it needs is another human to flick it. All it needs is another human to flick it. Turn it back on. You know, this Adam was on, the enemy came and turned him off from acknowledging God in all his ways. Turn him off. But you know what, though? He might have turned him off, but it was the breath of life was still in there. See, he turned him off. And the Lord God formed man in the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. See, even though man fell, the soul was still living because it was still hot. Even though man went off, it was still hot up there. Still hot. The switch needed to be flipped back up. God been trying to flip the switch up. And you got a bunch of people running around saying they saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, born again of God. And the switch is in the off position. But it's still hot up there. What makes it? Because you're still breathing. You still got the breath of life in your nostrils, which means it's still hot up there. You can be on again. You can be on again. You can be light on again. Matthew 5:14. Ye are the light of the world. You can be on again. Are you on again? We're gonna see what's turning you off and on today. Let's see what's turning you off and on today. Here we go. You gonna make me go there? Is this the beginning of the beach or the end of the beach? What is it? One and the same. Is it off or on? Is it off or on? One and the same. One and the same. The tree of the knowledge of good and evil. One and the same. Is it the beginning or the end? One and the same. Is it off or it's on? It's one and the same. You know, I've been talking to y'all about the Christ life, you know. The Christ life is the out of resurrection life of Jesus. See, when you're in the Christ life, you're one and the same. He is the God of the living and of the dead. One and the, he is the God of on and off. And because he's the God of on and off, it's hot. It should be hot right there, and it should be hot right there too. You should not be unstable in your living. Even when you're in the presence of people that are off, you should still be hot in the off position. Thou art inexcusable, old man, whosoever thou art, that sinneth. You ain't got no reason for sinning. We ain't got no reason for sinning because the out of resurrection life of Jesus is the God of the living and the dead, of the off and the on. God bless you, Ann. I love you, sis. Your life is the switch. Is it the Christ life? Are you living the Christ life, or are you living the Adam life? And the question is, who is doing the switching? Who's doing the switching? Because I'm telling you, the enemy could never turn Jesus off. The only reason why Jesus went to the off position was to save us. Because why? Because if the soul is left in darkness, sins will be committed. So Jesus came into the world receiving his electricity from the Christ life, and the enemy could never switch him off. And so when the enemy finally put a beating on the light switch, and when the light switch hung on that cross and says, "It is finished," and gave up the ghost and went to the off position, he went there still alive, taking the life of God into the death world so that he may be not only the God of the living, but also of the dead. He is the Christ life, the outer resurrection life. He is the life that came out of the off position that the enemy, the sin, put in the off position. He came out of the off position to put all of us back on. Because if the soul is left in darkness, sins will be committed. Here we go. Our problem. Man's problem is the circuit breaker. Here we go. The circuit. What's the circuit breaker? See, what's the circuit? Circuit is an established itinerary of events typically involving public performance. See, somebody got to break the way we act as a public people. Somebody's got to break that. So you got the circuit breaker. So the circuit breaker is an automatic device for stopping the flow of electricity as a safety measure. So the thing is this, you might have a light switch, but I tell you, this thing has got a wire running to a circuit breaker. So my thing is, your life, what switch, what circuit breaker are you connected to? Is God in the mind the circuit breaker that you're connected to? Or Satan in the flesh, is that the circuit breaker that you connected to? You know. Romans 7:14. For we know that the law is spiritual, but I am carnal, sold into sin. I'm carnal, sold in the off position. Adam sold us into the off position. I'm carnal, I'm a light switch. I can see that. I'm carnal, put into the off position by Adam and Eve. For that which I do, I allow not. I don't want to be in the off position. But for what I would, that do I not. I want to stay on, but I don't stay on. But what I hate, I hate being in an off position, but that is what I do. If then I do that, I would not. If I stay in the off position and I don't want to stay in the off position, I consent unto the law that it is good. I consent unto the off position that is good, because I want to be in the off position. I don't want to be in the off position. I want to be in the on position. Now then, it is no more I that do it, but sin that dwelleth in me. Ah, the electricity. Ah, an automatic device of stopping the flow of electricity as a safety measure. Now when there's no more I to do it, but sin that dwelleth in me. So if we stay connected to the flesh, then the electricity of evil is always going to dwell in us. For I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. For to will, to stay on, to stay the light of the world, is present with me. But how to perform it, how to perform it, how to stay on, I find not. How to perform that which is good, I find. For the good, for the staying on, that I would, I do not stay on. I find myself somehow keep going off, and the reason being is because a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. I'm telling you, this thing is simple to understand. For the good that I would, I do not. But the evil, which I would not, that I do. I tell you, you better check your circuit breaker. You better check your circuit breaker. Is God your circuit breaker? Is God the one supplying power? I tell you, God is supplying power to you, the light switch. If God is supplying power to you, you can shine whether you're on or off. Jesus never stopped shining. Jesus never stopped shining. On or off, he never stopped shining. If people flip you off, you keep shining. God bless you, Brother Bennett. I love you, sir. Talking about the light switch. Who is switching you? Who is doing the switching? I'm telling you, the enemy is just like he used the serpent to flip Adam and Eve from on to off. He's using humans to flip us on and off. And then we're running around like we ain't got no understanding. The Bible says, be not ignorant, lest Satan get an advantage over us, but we're not ignorant of his devices. The church is very ignorant of the enemy's devices because we're too busy looking at the outward appearance. The Lord says not in man, for man looketh on the, we looking too much on the outward appearance. We looking too much on the switch instead of looking at the circuit breaker. You gotta look at the circuit breaker. You gotta look at the automatic device for stopping the flow of electricity. As a safety man, you gotta look at what's stopping the flow of love in your life. It takes a circuit breaker to do that. The light switch is nothing. John 15:5. I am the vine. I'm the wire. And my father. No, we're gonna go. I'm the true vine. I'm the true circuit breaker. We're going to go to John 15. And my father is the husband. He's the one that gives the power. See, the circuit breaker needs to get power. And then the circuit breaker gives power to the light switches. I am the vine. I'm the vine. I'm the wire that runs to the circuit, to the switches. You are the switches. He that abideth in me, and I am the same, shall bring forth much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. I tell you, life switch can't do nothing without circuit breaker. Can't do nothing. You trip a switch in the house. You go on and plug something in and watch the circuit breaker trip. Go on. See, that's what happened. Your serpent caused Adam and Eve to trip the circuit breaker. And God's been trying to turn the circuit breaker of life back on. But we won't let him flip. He flips the circuit breaker on in love. The circuit breaker that the enemy tripped was called love. And you know what, though? And so now we, in our double-mindedness, and in our unstable ways, we choose who we want to love and who we don't want to love. We choose that based off of the electricity that we're getting from the circuit breaker.
Okay, got all this black movement mess going on.
Because when that officer killed George Floyd, when them two men killed Ahmaud Arbery, when they shot up Breonna Taylor, I tell you, it flipped off some Bible-believing people's switch.
It turned off a lot of people's switches. But I tell you, the Christ life, the resurrection life of Jesus
God would have went right back in there and flipped the circuit breaker back on.
So that the light switch can work again. I tell you, even in the off position, it's still hot up there. God says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. You just won't let me flip you back on. You won't let me flip you back on. If you let me be your circuit breaker, no matter what the enemy does, he will not be able to flip. He can't flip me off.
The enemy can't. There is nothing the enemy can do that can turn
the circuit breaker, the Christ life, into the off position. If Christ is your life, I want to know why the circuit breaker is constantly being tripped in your life. I want to know why.
This mess is them took in place since even with the COVID-19 mess. None of that mess flipped the switch yet in my life. And you know, and people that is them flip the switch in their life, they ain't got problems with Pastor Red. Because there's nothing the enemy can do that can flip off this circuit breaker.
You can't flip off the circuit breaker that's given me my life. The Christ life cannot be. The enemy, the Bible says it was impossible for death to hold him.
So he can't flip him. So death can't flip. So why is death flipping you and you running around saying you a Christian? Saying you born again. Saying you saved, sanctified, and Holy Ghost filled. Do you know what? From the circuit breaker
to the light switch, from the circuit breaker to the light switch, flows the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit is the power from the circuit breaker to the light switch. There is nothing on planet Earth that can turn off the Holy Ghost in your life but you. You are the only person that can turn off the Holy Ghost in your life. And I tell you, I'm telling you, we've been turning him off. We've been judging people. We've been choosing to agree with people. Nobody's remaining under the power of the circuit breaker of God, the outer resurrection life of Jesus, the Christ life. Verse 20, now if I do that I would not, now if I do stuff in the opposition that I don't want to do, it's no more me doing this, but sin that dwelleth in me. When this thing is in the opposition, no matter whatever this is going to, whatever it's plugged into, there should be no power coming out of it. So this switch is working a socket on the wall that a fan is in. That fan should no longer be on. That fan shouldn't be on. I want to know why you on. I want it because we're dead. Romans chapter 6. Know ye not as many as us as were baptized into Jesus Christ was baptized into his death. So we said our earth suit should be in the off position. Meaning none of the works of the flesh should be in operation. The evil, the hatred, the lying, the blasphemy, the cursing out, the fornicating, the adulterating, the stealing, the backbiting should be turned off. It should be turned off. But you know what, here goes the Paul says that if I'm still doing that, but you know, it's not me doing it, but it's sin that's dwelling in, it's the sin that's supplying the electricity. I find in the law that when I would do good, evil is present with me. I tell you, a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. I find in a law that when I would do good, evil is present with me. Yeah, because it's the tree that Adam ate from. He gave us that life. We sold under sin. I find in a law that when I would do good, evil is present with me. I told you. This thing is never not without power. You're getting the power from God on, you're getting the power from sin off. If Christ is your life in the off position, the same power that's running up here should be running in the off. The enemy should never be able to change you, no matter whether you up or down, count it all joy when you fall into the off position. Knowing that the trying of your faith works with patience. Whether you on or off, if Christ is your life, you should still be hot. you should still be like your father, who is a consuming fire, who's very hot. You should never not be hot with love. You should never be not be hot without with joy. You should never be without peace, long suffering, meekness. You should always be hot with them things. Verse 22, for I delight in the law of God after the inner man. You know, this is our problem right here, Brother Peachy. He says, for I delight. You know what people, you know what the people say, you know, because we think the word delight, we think the word delight means something good. No, D is a negative word. Deny, detest, denounce, defend. D is a negative, so that means, for I turn myself off in the law of God. I lay down my life. I lay down my life in the law of God after the inward man. Delight ain't no word of being happy. The Bible means, when the Bible says, when it says, delight yourself in the Lord, and he shall give, I mean, turn yourself off in the Lord, and he'll give you the desires of your heart. Delight! We think we lights. You know, we lean our own understanding thinking that we the light. No, we ain't the light. God bless you, sir. I love you. We only the light when he is upon us the power. Thy word is a lamp under my feet and a light unto my path. You ain't never a light. The only time you are light is when you are light that is in the vine. I am the vine, you are the branches. The fruit is the light. You are the light of the world. You better be lighting up this world with the fruits of the Spirit. You ain't lighting up the world with the fruits of the Spirit. Then the enemy is your circuit breaker. For I delight in the law of God after the inward man, not after the outward man. But I see another law in my members that's supposed to be dead, that's supposed to be water baptized, warring against the law of my mind, because my mind is now governed by a new circuit breaker. The mind of Christ, the outer resurrection life of Jesus. Warring against the law and bringing me into captivity to the law of sin which is in my members. Now, how in the world can that bring it when the Bible says that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, the casting down of imagination, bringing every thought captive. We supposed to bring every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. But rather than us bringing every thought captive to the obedience of Christ, we're allowing sin that is in our members to bring us into captivity to the law of sin which is in our members. See, Adam and Eve put sin in our members. Adam and Eve put sin in there. Sin had never been in it. But Christ put life, whether you're in the own position or off position, Christ life functions in both. He is the outer resurrection life of Jesus. He told Martha, I am the resurrection and the life. Lady, I am both. I am the on position and the off position, lady. And if you abide in me, you can do the same. For without me, you can do nothing, lady. You need me in the on position. You need me to be your circuit breaker when you're in the on position and when another human puts you in the off position. You need me to be your circuit breaker.
Oh, wretched light switch that I am. Oh, wretched light switch that I am. Who shall deliver me from the body of this death? I thank God.
I thank God. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
So then with the mind,
I serve the law of God. But with the flesh, the law of sin.
With the mind, I serve the law of God, but with the flesh, the law. So you got two circuit breakers.
So man's problem is the circuit breaker. Are you serving the law of God through the mind, or are you serving the law of sin through the flesh? The problem is the circuit breaker.
Because we were powered by a bad circuit breaker named sin at birth, God, because he loved us, gave us a new circuit breaker named Christ through water baptism. Therefore, if any man be in the new circuit breaker,
he is a new creature.
Old things are passed away, meaning old things, which means it doesn't make a difference if you off or on. It's passed away. Old things, this old flipping you off and on is over. It doesn't work. The switch don't work no more. Switch don't work no more. Because you can't flip off it. Because sin was never able to flip Jesus off. So that means the circuit breaker never trips. The Christ life never trips. Now under him that is able to keep you from falling.
Because if that circuit, the Christ life won't trip. You can't trip it. That what any man being Christ, he's a new thing. Old things, the old circuit breaker, the cross did away with the old circuit breaker. Behold, all things have become new. Got a new circuit breaker that there is nothing in this world that can trip it. I want to know why you trip. I want to know why you trip it. I want to know why the body of Christ is constantly being observed in the off position, not exhibiting the fruits of the Spirit, mainly love. There's no love. There's no love in a bunch of God's so-called children. And the reason for it is because they're being governed by a bad circuit breaker. A circuit breaker named Adam that Satan tripped. And now, rather than living by the Spirit, our bad circuit breaker Adam lives by the flesh and by what he sees. And God is looking for dead men who are telling him that they understand this battle, and they don't understand it. They don't understand that the enemy is going to come to see if he can trip the circuit breaker.
He took Jesus into the wilderness three times. He tried to trip the circuit breaker, the Christ light. Jesus was the light switch. Jesus was the circuit breaker. I mean, Christ was the circuit breaker. Jesus was the light switch. Christ was the circuit breaker. The enemy could never trip him because Jesus stayed submitted to the Christ life in every test the enemy put him through. And we say we bear that same life. We say we got that same spirit. And no matter what happens in the world, them light switches, them circuit breakers is tripping, pow, going in the opposition, pow, going in the opposition. The circuit breaker of God should never be down there. It should never be down there. It should always be in the up on position. Satan was never able to trip the Christ life circuit breaker. An automatic device for stopping the flow of electricity. He was never able to trip the Christ light from what Jesus says. He says, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. See, we need to see the earth ship needs living water. Humans need living water. See, through the electricity of the Holy Ghost, living water is able to flow out of our bellies and come out of our mouth and feed people with love and forgiveness and words of grace. The circuit breaker. You got a circuit breaker problem. You got a circuit breaker problem. The church has a circuit breaker problem. Listen to what he says in John 15, 7 through 13. If you abide in me, the new circuit breaker, and my words abide in you, the electricity, because the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. See, if you abide in the electricity of what I am talking, which is spirit and life, ye shall ask what ye will and it shall be done unto you. Herein is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit, so shall ye be my disciples. As the Father hath loved me, so have I loved you. So, you know, so Georgia Power has to feed electricity to my circuit breaker panel. So God is Georgia Power. My circuit breaker panel is the Christ life. The Christ life feeds me. God, the Georgia Power, is love, feeding Christ love, feeding me love. The light switch. As the Father hath loved me, so have I loved you. Continue ye in my love, whether you are in the off or on position, continue in my love. God bless you, Sister Selena. I love you. If you keep my commandments, if you remember this, ye shall abide in my love, in my electricity. Even as I have kept my Father's commandments, even as I have stayed in the electricity of my, that the Father supplied me, and abiding in his love, these things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, whether you in the on or the off position.
and that your joy might be full, whether you're in the own or the opposition. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you in the on and the off position. Greater love hath no man than this, than that a man, even in his off position, lay down his life for his friends. We're going to close right here. Genesis chapter 4, verse 1 through 5. And Adam and Eve, and Adam knew Eve his wife, and the two switches that was turned off knew each other, and the female off switch conceived and bare Cain. In her off position, governed by the flesh and Satan circuit breaker, said, I have gotten a man from the Lord. Then she again bade his brother Abel. And Abel was the keeper of the sheep, but Cain a tiller of the ground. Two different light switches. And in the process of time, it came to pass that the light switch that tilled the ground brought of the fruit of the ground an offering unto the Lord in the opposition. And Abel, he also brought of the firstlings of the flock and of the fat thereof. And the Lord had respect unto Abel in his offering from the light switch perspective. I wonder how in the world did Abel know to offer the flock, and Cain didn't, but Cain was born before Abel. But under Cain and his offering, he had not respect. I got to go back here? Y'all want me to go back here? Don't. I know where y'all want me to go. You want me to go all the way back to right here? Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not into thine own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. See, Cain leaned his own understanding, and he didn't acknowledge God so that God could direct his path. But God loves us, so God's going to try to direct this guy's path. But Cain, and to his offering, God didn't have respect, and Cain was mad. And his countenance fell. For Cain was mad, trying to worship God, give God all the glory, the honor, and the praise from his understanding, rather than seeing that God had respect in the Abels and the, oh, I better do this away. And the Lord said unto Cain, You know why the Lord spoke unto Cain? If the soul is left in darkness, sins will be committed. The guilty one is not he who commits the sin, but he who causes the darkness. It's the circuit breaker. It's the circuit breaker that's causing the darkness. It ain't the light switch on the wall. The light switch can be in the own position, and you can still lose power in your house. It's because something's tripping. There's something wrong with the circuit breaker. So what am I trying to say? I'm trying to say the believer, the person that says they're a believer never comes off on. They're going to believe today, they're going to believe tomorrow, they're going to believe until they die. So if they never come off on, then what is stopping the flow of electricity? It is the circuit breaker. It is the circuit. Forget the off and the on. Ain't got nothing to do with the switch no more. Because as a believer, you're always, you know, you're always gonna stay hot. You're always gonna stay in the on position. So the problem is the circuit breaker. The problem is what's supplying power to the light switch. If the soul is left in darkness, sins will be committed. The guilty one is not he who commits the sin. Cain finna commit the sin, but it's he who causes the darkness. The circuit breaker causes the darkness. Man's problem is the circuit breaker. Is God in the mind of Christ, is that the circuit breaker governing you? Or is it Satan in the external fleshly living, controlling the living? Always connected to the vine. Always connected to, and Brother Preacher, that's the thing with that. If you're connected to the vine, how in the world are you not bearing the fruit of that vine? How are you not bearing the fruit of that vine? You're a calm old person. We know all about circuit breakers and stuff. If the vine ain't broke, if the wire's not been cut, if the wire's not disconnected, if there's nothing wrong with the vine, then the problem is the circuit breaker. The source that the electricity flows from to get to the light switch. Who's constantly saying they're saved, sanctified, and Holy Ghost filled, who will not never denounce that they're not believers or Christians, which means they're telling us that they're always in the on position. The on position is always hot, even if the switch is in the off, the on position stays. So if you're on, then that means you're not unstable in all your ways. But I want to know why you're not. Your love ain't hot from the other race. Why your love ain't hot for your fellow man. Oh yeah, Brother Peter, there's connectivity. We will bear the fruit of the vine. But Brother Peter, there is connectivity and there is no fruit being born. Ain't nobody bearing the fruit. And there ain't even a connectivity problem. So that leads us to believe that because there's no electricity, then the problem is with the circuit breaker. Because it ain't nothing wrong with the Christ light. And he says, I am the vine, you the branches. I'm the wire, you the light switch. Ain't nothing wrong with the vine. Ain't nothing wrong with the wire. But there's a problem with the circuit breaker. So, the vine, the wire said unto the light switch, why in off position? And what's wrong with the electric? And why is the countenance falling? Who knocked you in the off position? What you mad about? And who knocked you in the off position? If you do well, you'll be accepted. If you do well, all you got to do is do what he's doing. I'll accept you. But if you don't do well, sin lieth at the door. Oh yeah, Brother Biggs.
That circuit breaker cast us in the darkness,
but we better not stay there. We got to go to
the panel and reflip the circuit breaker on. You know how we do that, Brother Peaches? Did you know we go back? You know that word I'm looking for. How do we go to the circuit panel and flip the circuit breaker back on? What's the word we should call that? Do anybody know the word we should call how to turn the circuit breaker back on? Do we know what that's called? Starts with an R. The circuit breaker cast us, starts with an R, Brother Peachy. How do we turn the circuit breaker back on? Starts with an R. How we turn it on? How do we turn the circuit breaker on? It's easy. If we allow sin to turn off the circuit breaker, the Y ain't went nowhere. The Y says, I never did. Brother Peachy, close though. You got the R-E right. If we do something, we got to do something. How do we turn the circuit breaker back on? You got the first two letters, Brother Peachy. Give it to me. What did God tell us to do to get the circuit breaker to come back on? Because we are already in the resurrection. We're in the Christ life. It is the outer resurrection life of Jesus. Give it to me, Peachy. Give it to me. I'm waiting. I ain't going till you give it to me. All Cain had to do was one thing. Cain had the opportunity to turn the circuit breaker back on. What is it? R-E. There we go, Peachy. That's how you turn the circuit breaker back on, Brother Peachy. We have to repent. If we repent, the circuit breaker comes back on. And we come out of darkness and back into His marvelous light. Oh yeah, we repent. Let's see if Cain did that. You know what, Cain? If you do well, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, you can act with willingness to be done unto you. You know, Cain, if you do well, thou shalt be accepted. But if you don't do well, Cain, if you don't abide in my word, you know, sin lies at the door ready to take over your life and switch you into the off position. Switch you off into the off position where you're not going to love your brother anymore. And unto thee shall be his desire, and thou shalt rule over him. And Cain talked with Abel, his brother, and it came to pass when they were in the field that Cain, you know, I can hear the conversation now, Brother Peter. I can hear him now. It was a jealous conversation. It was a jealous conversation. He was probably trying to get Abel to do something against what Abel was doing, because you know Abel knew Psalms 1:1 says, "Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful, but his delight is in the law of the Lord." Abel saw that his offering was getting respect, and Cain was probably trying to get Abel not to do that type of offering, but to follow him in the way that he gave his offering. Yeah, just like y'all want, the people want you to follow them out there to support the Black Lives Matter movement. People want y'all to follow them to wear your I Can't Breathe t-shirt. People, the Canes who got the light switch turned off. No, they still got the light switch on, but the circuit breakers turned off. They want you to follow them as they walk in darkness. We're not of the night, we are the day. And Cain talked with Abel's brother, and it came to pass
When they were in the field, then Cain rose up against Abel, his brother, and slew him because his circuit breaker was off. In the electricity of love flowing through him was no longer there. And so he slew his brother. But I tell you, the after resurrection life of Jesus, the one that can live in life and in death, came to Cain and said to Cain, "Where is Abel thy brother?" And he said, "I know not." I tell you, that circuit breaker was off, and it was working that darkness in Cain to perfection. Am I my brother's keeper? Yeah, you are. Yes, you are. You know what, Brother Peace, I'm your keeper. That's why I preach the way I preach. Oh yeah, Brother Peace. Stay in the outer resurrection life, in the ark, and away from the courts of this world. If they living with the same circuit breaker that we living with, they can do that. Where is Abel thy brother? He said, "I know not. Am I my brother's keeper?" And he said, "What hast thou done? The voice of thy brother's blood crieth unto me from the ground." There is nothing you can do, whether the switch, the circuit breaker is on, or whether the circuit breaker is off, that God does not know. Be sure that your sin will find you out, because you cannot turn off the Christ life circuit breaker switch. And if you can't turn off the Christ life circuit breaker switch, then the Christ life sees everything you do. The only time that the circuit breaker switch of sin was running things was in Genesis 1 and 2. In the beginning, God created the heavens and earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And God said, "Time to put a circuit breaker on this mess." He threw the circuit breaker into the world of darkness, and he flipped that thing on. And Satan says, "I am back in the light." But what God did was, God said, "No, you're not. I'm going to separate you. I'm still going to separate you from me. I'm still going to separate you. I'm going to make a light switch. But I'm going to have it connected to a circuit breaker." In man, and I'm going to create a living soul, a creature called man, and I'm going to let him, I'm going to create a free will being, and I'm going to let him make a choice as to whether or not which circuit breaker he wants to be governed by. If he wants to be governed through the mind of Christ, or whether he wants to be governed by his flesh, I'm going to let him make that choice on his own, as to what circuit breaker. And so the Lord God took the man, and then put him into the Garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every circuit breaker that is in the garden, you may freely take electricity from it. But of the circuit breaker that is in the midst of the garden, called the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you don't take no electricity from that. Because in the day that you take the electricity from it, he's going to turn you off, put you in darkness, and you're going to die. God never hid the off switch from man. He put him in the on position, and man allowed the serpent to put him in the off position. And God does not want to leave us in darkness, because if the soul is left in darkness, sins will be committed. Because we were powered by a bad serpent breaker named sin at birth, God, because he loves us, gave us a new serpent breaker named Christ through water baptism, so that we can learn how, so that we can live a life of love uninterrupted by anything life throws at us. I'm telling you, we just need to let the power
fall. Let your power fall.
This Monday, a new job, this past Monday.
interview three times for this dog. It's a denial. Oh, but this time, I interview. They call me. They call me. A dog I interview three times, and they said, no, no, no. The circuit breaker. The life of self-control. He'll give you the desire of your heart. Why to the station to change that you desire?
Connected to the right circuit breaker. Three times, Brother Peachy, three times I interviewed for the job, and they chose somebody else. But I was at work, and I got a phone call, and they said, are you interested in the job? And I was like, yes, I've interviewed for the job three times. They said, it's yours to turn down. We're not going to talk with anybody else unless you tell us you don't want it. You tell me God ain't aware of what we want, what we desire, what we crave, what we patiently wait for. He's aware. You just gotta make sure that you don't let the light switch be connected to the wrong circuit breaker, to a bad circuit breaker. Make sure your light switch is connected to the circuit breaker of Jesus, who is love. Oh, you're not getting away from this song. I'm not gonna let y'all get away from it. not letting me get away from this song. The circuit breaker. Our circuit breaker. Our circuit breaker. Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord.
Father.
He can hear you. He can see you. He knows what you're going through. He knows everything. The circuit breaker. Our problem is the circuit breaker. I pray to God that you will let him be your circuit breaker. Let him be your circuit breaker. God loves you. I love you. Thank you for joining me today. I pray that you got something out of today's message. Keep on believing God for the things that you want, the things that you need. You know, I want to talk about this new job of mine. I think I interviewed 3 times for this thing and didn't get it. And then when they called me, I told them, I take a $3 pay cut. The people like, no, we're going to give you a pay raise. You know, God will bless you for your faithfulness to him. In the pandemic, in a racial, heated world that we're living in right now, because I have refused to bow to the oppression and the weight of it, God has blessed me with something that I've been after for a while. I believe he blessed me with that because of my faithfulness. He's blessed me this year. Increased my VA disability 40%. Blessed me with a new job. He's just been blessing me this year. Blessing me with the greatest church members I could ask anybody for. My life is just right where I'm happy right now with where God has me at. And I want to thank my members and the followers for sticking with me and being there with me. Thank you, Sister Ann, for staying with me. God bless my Sister Ann too. Ann is just going to keep opening up doors for you. You watch and see, don't you? Continue to open doors for you. Because you got a beautiful heart, and God sees your heart. Man looketh on the outward appearance, but God looks on the heart. Keep loving people in spite of their love for us. You just keep loving them. Don't let nobody turn you into the off position. Continue to love. Continue to pray for them to despitefully use you and persecute you. Stay in love. Stay in the love of the Lord. Stay connected to the new circuit breaker. Oh yeah, but all our faith is, because we get our faith from them. The enemy wants to make us believe we can't achieve what we want. But you'll get it. But you gotta stay connected to the new circuit breaker, so that electricity will flow into you and you'll have the power to obtain that which you desire. I love y'all. I will see you Thursday night, God willing. Only way I won't be a Thursday night is something in the world going to happen, but I don't have no intentions of not being here Thursday night. I miss y'all. That 7-day break ain't good for me. Not being in the front of my flock that long. I love y'all. Thank you for waiting for me. Thank you for being here for me. Oh yeah, and you keep thanking him and he gonna keep on blessing me. I love you. Brother Pizza, you spoil my sister, rotten tomorrow. God, then God gonna wake her up to see a beautiful July the 6th. Amen. With a husband that loves her with all his heart. I always pray for y'all's marriage so God will continue to strengthen it and your children with y'all. I love you, Sister Selena. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I love all y'all. Thank you for joining me today. Thank you for taking the time out of this July the 5th to spend it with me to hear what I have to say to y'all from my Bible study time with God. I will see you Thursday night. God bless you. Amen and amen.